Well, as a kid, I used to go to a lot of movies. And I still do, and I'm still a kid. Proved that in more ways than one. But I enjoy it. I'm in my own little world, man. At any rate, I thought I'd give you, everybody loves Robin Hood. My wife digs Richard Green, and he is a good-looking cat, you know. Yeah, wavy hair, comes on pretty strong. And especially, in the opening, he shoots right straight with that commercial, you know. And in the opening scene, they're all around a fireplace. And one thing about these cats, man, they all swing pretty good. They've got a lot of chops, and a half a roast beef there and a head of a pheasant. And they're, Robin, how are you? And they're all jumping around. Little John's there. He's kind of a weird cat. He's sawed off. He's about that high.
Hi, Robin. How are
you? Oh, yeah, a little mixed up. But the guys dig him, And, there's Friar Tuck knocking Presbyterians in the water. And, Anglicans, whatever they were. I don't know, And, so they're just sort of sitting around. There's Maid Marian and a beautiful chick, but nobody seems to be, nothing going on there. She just sort of,
hi, Robin.
Too much, too. Well put together, but she just sort of in and out of camp. It's kind of a weird scene. I don't know what's going on. Well, they all sing around the table, Robin's a friend, Robin's a friend, Robin's a friend, and they throw the roast beef up in the air. You've seen them. Heavy goblets and going at the juice hard. Because they're poor, anybody's poor juices it. And it bugs them, So suddenly through the forest, they hear the sound of horns, It's the king's men, a group of horny men coming through the forest. Well, I hope I didn't, Oh, let's face it, friends, when you're working for the government, you get horny. And, they come through and they've got sort of these sheet metal things on it, sort of a riding sheet metal shop is what it is, and they're riding along, And suddenly these cats swing out of the trees and their little arrows bouncing off the sheet metal, and they stab a couple of, get off me. And somebody invented gunpowder, but they didn't get it. So then Little John, they meet after they get all these guys on the ground. And Little John comes over to Robin and he says,
Robin, Princess Mary Louise Louise is over in the castle.
And he's crazy. So they throw all the beef into the fireplace and, stomp it out because Smokey the Bear doesn't dig fires. And they jump on this horse and it's a borrowed horse. And Robin's on there with about six other guys, so you can imagine how the horse is, kind of bent down and skids in there. So Robin looks up and he sees Princess Mary Louise Louise in this great castle, man. It's too much, great big thing. It's paper mache, but the kids don't know that. They're eating their Clark bars there, Oh, boy, look. And I'm way in the back row and I'm waiting for the princess to come out. And she does. She comes out in sort of this dirty gray muslin dress, and sneakers kind of turned inboard. And Robin's been in the forest a little long, though, and he checks her over pretty good. And not too much, long braid, sort of a naughty kid. And not too much upstairs, but from here on down, gangbusters. And he's got a little rope, and he, he's been at rehabilitation back in camp. So scurries up there, and they kiss and hold on real good. A lot of it has to be cut for the kids because they get bored, but the adults, they get, And she goes in and sits in her little powder room there and makes up and everything, and they talk, and Robin says that he's been in the forest and everything, and she knows that. And suddenly through a heavy door, it's about that thick, give or take a couple inches, it swings open, and in comes the Black Knight, who is a bad cat. He's all, iron, bent plumes and everything. He says, you're Robin of Sherwood. And everybody, boo. No, they don't dig him. And,
I see, I've been waiting for you.
He whips out this little sword, which isn't too good. He made it himself. But it's got phony little jelly beans in it for jewels, And they go at it and out on the terrace, jumping over things, and statues and everything. He misses him a couple of times. But finally, he gets the Black Knight in a vulnerable spot. We don't have to telegraph where it would be, but, sort of a can opener effect. And this, he falls into this dry moat, which is just full of dead catfish and everything, slimy turtles and everything, frogs and that jazz. And
Sir Robin says, good luck to you. That'll teach you, Daddy.
See, it's sort of a hip version of Robin. And so by this time, her dad comes in, who looks like H.B. Warner after a tornado, you know. He's a bright wig and a little tiny crown, which is fake. And he's got these flowing robes, the ermine tails, live ermines, too. Keeps him moving, you know. And,
my son, thank you.
He mumbles his part. He's only getting $87.50 for the whole thing. And Robin kisses his hand, because that's what they did in those days, you know, both hands sometimes. And she says, oh, I'm so thankful. And they kiss again. And it's a bad scene. And then Robin steps back, you know, because he recognizes authority when he sees it. Pulls out the sword again. To your liege, the rightful heir to the throne.
Oh, jeez.